After extensive screening of students from Imperial College London, 16 high-calibre students were selected to participate in the 2012 Imperial Apprentice Challenge. Four teams must battle it out to represent Imperial in the London University Apprentice Challenge. The winning team will also receive cash and prizes from sponsors Procter & Gamble.
Hello and welcome to the 2012 Imperial Apprentice. Over the next 48 hours, you will face four challenges, which will test your entrepreneurial abilities to the limits. There are 16 of you here, divided into four teams. But only one team will be crowned Imperial Apprentice champions and will be able to represent Imperial College at the London Apprentice 2012 final.
Okay, your first task is the strategy challenge. For this challenge, you need to obtain value from nothing. So your first task is to go out and obtain an item for free. It's probably going to be something low value, and then gradually meet people and trade your item up and up and up until you obtain an item of high value. So the team that obtains the most valuable item will win, but you'll also be marked on teamwork, management and strategy. You have 2 hours, let your task begin.
Hello, we are Team Zeus and we are here to win.
My name is Tarek, I'm doing a postgraduate degree in finance. I decided to join Apprentice to strengthen my entrepreneurial abilities.
Hi, I'm John. I'm a first-year biochemist. I'm here because I want to learn about business.
Hi, my name is Aaron. I'm a mechanical engineer. I joined the Apprentice last year and I really enjoyed myself and I'm back for more fun.
I'm going to take a look at the item. I'm going to sell it and then I'm going to get the item. I'm going to get the item. I'm going to get the postcard.
Initial negotiations with the shop owner did not seem promising, but Tarek eventually managed to obtain a free postcard by utilising his linguistic skills. After much struggle, Team Zeus managed to sell the card for £3. They then had to decide what to do with it.
I think the only way is to go to Kensington in those small shops. Here there are big shops. It's hard to
go to small shops and do what?
Get postcards again and get cards again and sell it again. Keep on doing this. Three until it becomes small.
But we have to use this tree. So, are we okay with it?
I can't.
There's not even a comp for us, very high. £3, it means I should take a loss for myself then. Giving you £3. You love London? What do you hit then? Take that one for £3. There's £4, but you can have it for £3.
This is £3.
Yeah, for you £3.
Okay, thank you so much.
Capitalising on weather conditions enabled them to sell the umbrella swiftly. The money was reinvested and the team ended up with £20.
£10, bought it for three, we can go buy a couple more.
We are Team Tornado and we are here to win this.
My name is Ignacio Lubar, I'm a first year undergraduate of a student in aeronautical engineering here at Imperial College. And I consider this experience really useful.
Hello, I am Sabrina Ghidi. I'm doing a Master in Innovation, Entrepreneurship and Management. I am here because I love challenges.
Hi, I'm Isabel. I'm from MSc Innovation Entrepreneurship as well. I'm here to put my skills in practice.
Hi, my name is Yafiki Tata. I'm studying Innovation Entrepreneurship Masters at the Business School and I'm here to win this challenge.
Team Tornado first targeted students for a free item and managed to obtain free items.
Wow,
thank you so much!
Okay, wait,
what will we sell?
Nothing, no chocolate.
If you want to pay my pocket, I'm going to pay for
trying to trade items, and if you have anything that would be valuable and we can sell it to someone else, if you can give it to us. So we got headphones and we got a green chain, and we want something else. If you have anything, we had a pen at the beginning, and whatever you have, just give it to us. We can give you headphones.
linguistic skills, Serena managed to charm a commuter into trading headphones with a hand.
Okay. Requesto.
Che cos'è?
Quello spray per l'igienizzante per le mani.
Per le mani, ricerco le
Grazie.
Grazie, veramente, grazie mille.
Scusa,
ho preferisce questo. Quello. Va bene quello. Grazie veramente ragazzi, grazie mille. Ok.
Is there any chance you could give us like one of those and so that we can leave? Because that's the whole thing. We are going to give you something, like a pair of headphones or something.
I'm asking
and you can give us a packet of this.
Why is it tasty?
Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tornado exchanged their final item for the money on a restaurant table, making the team £21.
Hi, our team's called Ipsum. And this is our team.
Hello, my name is Grace and I'm second year biochemist. The reason why I joined this competition is because I want to challenge myself more and gain more, improve my own skills.
Hi, I'm Andreas. I'm a first year aeronautics student and I'm doing this because I want to make the most of my time at Imperial.
Hi, my name's Amrik. I'm a 1 year MSc student studying risk management and I want to do something creative because my course is quite analytical.
Hi, my name is Gary. I'm a final year biomedical sciences student, and I'm doing this competition because I want to push myself and I want to learn and to make the most out of this weekend and to just have fun.
Following a series of exchanges, Ipsum stumbled across an American couple who donated their laptop case for a scarf.
I'll just put a price of 15 quid and then...
But no, but that's not worth it for you.
What?
If that's worth 15 quid, then you get the point. I mean, there's no point in putting it on eBay.
Unless
you sell for more than it's worth, but which you won't.
What would you say that's worth?
Whatever it's worth, like when we look it up after. I don't know. I'm just going to guess 20 something. I don't know.
Returning to the business school, the team discovered some good news regarding the price of the laptop case.
I'm going to try and see how much it costs at this Sony. What model is that? What's the number? No, you saw it. What's the number?
It's VGP.
VGP.
Hyphen. CKZ1.
CKZ1.
It's no longer available. It's Sony stock.
68 quid at 4 stores. Look. Oh my god. Look. 68, 70, 73, 72.
Who's the guy that gave this?
I'm rich American.
Yeah. Do we have to give it back?
No.
So
we traded the book for a scarf. Oh, who's taking this at the end?
Oh my god, okay. I think we just settled. It's 70 quid.
We've got 10 minutes left.
Yeah, we can't do it. How are we supposed to make more than 70 quid? Seriously.
Is it dollars or pounds?
Pounds! New. Okay, new is 70 quid. I'd say used would be 50.
But it's looked new, so I guess
that would be...
Yeah.
That was generous. He did that for a scarf.
No. He didn't even really want the scarf. He was going to thrust the scarf in his face just because we had to get rid of it.
He's rich. So, and maybe it's because we have an American accent or something. And she's Asian. And we're Asian. And yeah, you're Asian as well. No, actually all of us are Asian.
We are
Team Collateral.
My name is Andre Nackert. I do MSc Innovation and Entrepreneurship Management. And my favorite animal is cheetah.
Hi, my name is Max Dubenval. I'm a first year chemistry undergraduate at Imperial College London. And my favorite animal is a leopard.
Hi, my name is Hari Ravindran. I'm a first year chemical engineering student at Imperial College London. And my favorite animal is a tiger.
Hello, my name is Alex, and I'm doing aeronautical engineering. Emmanch, it's Pearl, and my favorite animal is the lion, because it's the king.
So we start with half a pot of cocoa powder,
and we met a nice lady on the street. We stopped it for a sealed bag of peanut M&Ms, and then we went to a hotel and we swapped those M&Ms for a nice bag of chocolates. And then, and that nice bag of chocolates we traded with the driver for a £110 corporate voucher, corporate car hire voucher. And he's got to keep the chocolates, so we have like a gift bag worth about £120 now. And so yeah, we're very excited. We're gonna go to the Mandarin Oriental now, see if we can sell it to anyone who is taking a car to Heathrow. Maybe for an inflated price to make some more money. Or swap it for something of even higher value.
Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Fine, how are you?
My name is Andre.
Hi, nice to
meet you. I'm doing great.
Good.
What's your name?
Heidi.
Heidi. Well, we're doing a challenge. Students, Imperial College.
Okay.
Apprentice. Do you know the program?
No.
Well, we have to trade items up.
Okay.
We got some chocolates.
Okay.
And a voucher from Central London to Heathrow Airport in a BMW 7 Series limo.
Okay.
£110 worth.
Okay.
Can't trade it up. Nobody wants it.
Can we trade it with a higher value restaurant voucher?
Which nobody wants this. We're losing.
I don't think, I mean, I'm not the general manager, but I don't think they wouldn't give you a voucher for like over £110.
What kind of value would you give us?
I wouldn't be able to do it myself. You'd need the general manager to come in because I can't authorise it. But I mean, even if she'd do it, I don't think it'd be anywhere near that. Honestly, just because she wouldn't, it's like giving away.
Yeah, yes, she can trade with us. like a nice bottle of wine or.
Meanwhile, back in the business school.
So you think that like, you need to push someone hard, but if you push me, but I step back then. See, so you would have. Alex lost like every game.
Yeah. No what?
Get Max out. Looking hard.
Okay, so for that,
the wine.
After careful consideration, Team Collateral thought it would be a good idea to try and sell the wine to an Arab embassy.
Oh, selling one of it.
Having secured over £160 worth of goods, the team returned to the business school ready for the challenges that lie ahead.